Do you feel good? Are you bullish? Is this going to keep going?
We do feel good. I mean, you know, 3,100 was our target this year, which seemed crazy in January, or at least to a lot of other folks. And so the markets have kind of played out the way that we had expected. We thought that the global slowdown in the first part of the year would lead to stimulus and kind of a reacceleration. We think we're seeing that. I think you always have to have humility at the highs. And so, you know, could we see a pullback? Sure, absolutely. But our view has been consistent. If there's no recession, the bull market's not over. I don't see a recession, so I'm not conceding the end of the bull market.
Let's put your portfolio manager hat on here, yeah, because that's your job to make asset allocation mm-hmm. decisions with markets at record highs. Are you starting to trim a little bit at these levels?
So we trimmed already. So we trimmed back in the kind of midsummer when we first hit that 2,900 level. We were at 8% overweight as a firm. We took that to 3. Seemed prudent, but actually was wrong at the time. I mean, we could have stayed with that 8% overweight. As we look now, and we think the economy is reaccelerating, we're looking to add, if anything. And we think there's some areas, both internationally and in the value part, the value cyclical part, especially on the small cap side, that look attractive.
All right, take us through the game plan. Where would you be adding on weakness here?
I think you've got to look at small cap value, actually. If you look at small caps in general, they still remain undervalued relative to large caps. They've lagged at least in the first part of the year. And we think on the value side, you've seen that yield curve steepen now significantly since Labor Day. You've got a lot of banks in that kind of small cap value. So that's an area we have our eye on.
So banks I've heard as a value theme for the better part of maybe 3 years or more at this
point.
Seems
like 30.
But it never yeah. seems like it really pans out. What makes it yeah. different this time around? Because the yield curve is still at historically relatively depressed levels.
It is, but it's a heck of a lot less depressed than it looked in August. And so, I mean, you've had 80 basis points of steepening. You know, we tend to look at the federal funds rate versus 10-year yield. You've had 80 basis points of steepening. Since that time, you've seen banks generate almost twice the return of the S&P 500. We think that could have legs. That doesn't mean we're going out and selling our growth. We still think that that's well positioned. But as you have cash to bring to the market, that's an area that we're looking at.
The safety trade has been a huge focus for so many investors over the course of the past 9 months, a better part of a year now. But we are seeing gold prices start to fall a bit. We're mm-hmm. seeing treasury yields spike. That mm-hmm. means treasuries are selling off. Some of these, you know, dividend-paying type names are starting to come off a little bit now. Does that rotation still happen? Do we think that there's still a trade getting out of safety assets?
I think dividend stocks are in for a much better 2 to 3 years going forward than they've been through over the last couple of years. Yes, you've seen rates come up a little bit, but they're still significantly lower than they were a year ago. And it's not the 10-year yield to look at. Look at the money market rate. No one sells a dividend stock to buy a treasury bond in a rising rate environment. So it's not the 10-year yield. It's about the money market rate. We've had 3 rate cuts. Money market rates have gone from 250 to 175. We think that rate difference is what pushes dividend stocks higher.